Please get ready for a dictation of exercise number 33 from legal material. 5 seconds. Start. Assuming that the labor court did make an award, but since same was not published, it was open to the presiding officer to pass a fresh award. There is no allegation of malafides or extraneous consideration, and consequently, the court is of the opinion that so long as the award was not published, it was open to the labor court to review its own order, which had been reserved and which had not been published. The court has perused the award and the findings given by the labor court on the various charges. The court finds that only charge number 5 has been proved and other charges have not been proved. The labor court has considered the evidence and has applied its mind, which the court does not find any fault. The reasoning given by the labor court is based on the material evidence on record, which this court is not inclined to interfere in a writ jurisdiction, since the court does not find that the finding of the labor court is perverse. Even for the sake of argument, assuming that the charge numbers 4 and 6 stood proved, the court is of the opinion that the cumulative effect of these charges were not that grave which would commensurate the penalty of termination of the services, and consequently, on this ground, the court is of the opinion that the order of termination was too harsh a punishment. Even though the labor court has gone into the evidence and has reconsidered the matter, which it ought not to do so unless the inquiry proceedings were vitiated, the court finds that the inquiry proceedings conducted by the inquiry officer was violative of the principles of natural justice. The inquiry officer has virtually given an ex parte report after considering various documents and reports given by various officers. Once an inquiry has been set up and a charge has been framed, the inquiry officer is required to conduct an inquiry in accordance with the principles of natural justice, meaning thereby that the inquiry officer has to cross-examine the witnesses and give an opportunity to the workman to cross-examine those witnesses. Giving an inquiry report on the basis of documents is by itself not sufficient. An opportunity to the workman ought to have been given, especially when the workman has denied charges. In the light of the aforesaid, the court finds that the inquiry proceedings was not conducted in a fair and proper manner, and consequently, the labor court, even though it has not set aside the inquiry report, considered the evidence on record and gave its evidence, the court is of the opinion that the award of the labor court could not be set aside on this ground itself. In the light of the aforesaid, the court does not see any error in the award of the labor court with regard to the reinstatement of the workman and giving a lesser punishment commensurate of the misconduct which stood proved in relation to charge number 4. The court, however, finds that the order of termination was passed in the year 2003. Conciliation proceedings were initiated in the year 2004. Reference was made by the state government in the year 2006, and the award was given in the year 2008, which was published in the year 2009. The court is of the opinion that considering these aspects, the award of full back wages in excessive, and consequently in the light of the aforesaid facts, coupled with the principle of no work, no pay, this court is of the opinion that the award of full back wages is likely to be modified and is substituted to 50% back wages, but with continuity of service. In the light of the aforesaid, the award of the labor court is modified. the order of reinstatement with the punishment is upheld and the award of the labor court of full back wages is modified to 50% back wages with continuity of service. Stop.